So in our first series here, we're going to look at sowing rates. Now, sowing rates is one of the most important aspects of production because it determines our yield. And there is a sort of relationship between how much seed we sow and what our yield is. As you might expect, as our sowing rate goes up, our yield goes up, but it's not quite that simple. So in this series, we're going to take a look at sowing rates with sunflower and wheatgrass. And we'll talk a lot about the particulars within that process as we go through. Now, to start this process, the first thing I did was basically decide what questions I'm trying to answer. And the basic question is, what is the optimum sowing rate for these two crops? I'm starting with a known sowing rate that I already use that I'm pretty happy with, but the experiment will help me get a better sense of whether that is the right rate and whether I can be making better use of my seed. Of course, this video isn't just about determining that sowing rate, it's also showing you how to figure this stuff out in your own system. So after I kind of came up with that question, I came up with a few hypotheses. And these are really drawing from experience. And there's three general hypotheses that I'm working with that I'm basically looking to prove or disprove in this experiment. So the general hypothesis is, starting at a low sowing rate, as the sowing rate increases, so does the yield, to a certain point at which the yield is going to start to decline. So there are two supporting hypotheses for that. The first one is that with too low of a sowing rate, even though seeds may germinate well, they won't be able to grow very well because they won't have enough strength to push the weight up on top of them in the germination process. And then the second one is, if our sowing rate is too high, there's going to be too much competition. And so each plant is competing with each other, and therefore that's going to bring the yield down. So these are things I know from experience, but I still like to have these hypotheses there because it helps me determine how I'm going to do the experiment. The next thing I did is a write-up. The links to the write-up will be posted in the video here. And the write-up has two parts. One is the general hypotheses and procedures and methods I'm going to follow, and the other is a spreadsheet where I'm going to record my data. So the reason to write this stuff out is, as you're writing out your methods, you're starting to get a sense of what you're going to do, how you're going to do it. And if you don't do that, what's going to happen is you're going to start doing stuff and realize, oh, actually, I forgot about this, or I forgot about that. And a bunch of stuff isn't gonna work out, or there's a risk that that's gonna happen, and therefore you're going to produce poor results. And if you're not producing good results, then your experiment really isn't even worth your time. If you're putting garbage in, you're going to get garbage out. So I like to write down my methods for each stage because it really helps me work through the process. And in doing so, I realized at many points, oh, I hadn't thought of this, I hadn't thought of that. So having done that, I feel like I'm in a good position to carry ahead with the experimenting. The other aspect of that is the spreadsheet, where I'm going to record all my data. So what crops I'm growing, my sowing dates, the different rates of sowing. And from that data, as I collect it, I'll be able to generate different statistics and analyze that data to get a sense of what the best sowing rate is and start to understand sowing rates a little better. Obviously, I can still make comments and observations along the way, and I can add those to the process as well. So there's so much, and I've done experiments like this before, but each time I do them, I learn quite a bit. And so I'll cover a lot of that as I'm going through the process. So let's start the process. So that's a bit of an introduction. Let's get into carrying out this experiment and determining what the best sowing rate is for both sunflower and wheatgrass.